Welcome to this week's Out in the Borderland. We're skiing the Ridge Trail in Voyageur's National Park, part of the Black Bay Trail System. A unique feature of this trail is that it's only accessible by water in summer for hiking, and ice road, yes, ice road is what we're on now, in winter. Right now, the ice road is good, and there's a little traffic, but come rush hour, watch out. The Ridge Trail put us through our paces. It's a difficult trail and not for everyone, but with our trusty guide, Brian Parmeter, a former Falls resident who is back to enjoy the snow, we're making it ever so slowly. So come along as we ski the ridge and take in some age-old ski tips from the Army Rangers circa 1940 in this edition of OITB.
The lack of ski control on the part of a trooper will cause a crack-up. Time must now be spent by the other members of the patrol in administering first aid and returning the injured skier to camp, clearly demonstrating how the military effectiveness and striking force of the entire patrol unit is destroyed. Since the snow on the downward side may be of a different texture, the men pick up a handful to inspect it in order to determine the proper wax to apply before commencing the descent. Inasmuch as the snow is not wet, they discard the wet snow wax, but select a can of wax suitable to its dry and powdery condition.
Thank you. this trail?
Well, I was back here in the 70s. I don't know if the trail was built then. But I've been coming back here and up in the Captoga Peninsula since high school.
Okay. And they just recently reopened this?
Yeah. A buddy of mine who was up in the UP left grad school. Actually, he graduated, and then he went to the Park Service. He was up at Isle Royale, and he worked up there for quite a few years. But then he moved over to Voyageur National. And when I heard that, I told him about the Ridge Trail and that it had been closed for many years. And he looked into it and saw it as a worthy endeavor and mobilized a whole bunch of good local volunteers who made it a trail again. Pretty cool.
Yeah, so you're down in South Carolina now. What's being able to come back up to the Ridge Trail here with all this beautiful snow like?
Oh, it's pretty dreamy. Pretty dreamy. It hasn't changed much. Which you can't say about a lot of places.
Right.
I'm definitely appreciative of this park. The clash of the titans to get it established was kind of dark to live through. Kind of polarized the people who side with the Bible and industry that see this as being here for us to dominate and use as we wish on the one hand, and people who can't find enough quiet places in the world on the other. It's about as quiet as it gets. Hey!
Emerging from a forest or any other dense area, the careful ski trooper will always stop to apply sunburn preventative to his face and neck in order to guard against painful complications. A trooper can become sunburned in winter just as easily as in summer, as in all weather, direct sunlight or reflected light from snow, fog, or clouds can cause a severe burn. This careless ski trooper has neglected to wear his snow goggles and is squinting against the glare of the sun as he travels along. Snow blindness is caused by direct and reflected rays of sunlight. The symptoms are a burning sensation in the eyes, which increases to intense pain and a sandy feeling in the eyelids. The eyes become red and swollen, and the victim is unable to look at any bright light or white surface. And frequently, he is unable to open his eyes.
Thank you.
We're getting into the prettiest part of this real soon here.
Yeah, I just have to remember to look up when I'm skiing or running to see this, all of the beautiful things.
You know, there's an awful lot that's interesting to look at on the ground, too. I sort of take umbrage to that old keep your eyes up, don't look down, you look so glum. There's all kinds of fascinating stuff to look at.
Yeah, we might have never seen that dog shit if we hadn't been looking.
Might have stepped right in.
Yeah. Especially when you're driving, I get so sick of people saying, keep your eyes on the road.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous. Service means to a community like the Falls?
I guess in my opinion, take a longer view of what the value of a resource like this is. You know, urban sprawl hasn't really stopped. And people are more and more needing this. I think in the long term, recreation is a better bet than industry. My two cents worth. I tell you, my nickname used to be Pine Cone.
No.
I wore it proudly.
How about you, Ms. Bolden?
What do I think the value of a park like this is for the community of International Falls?
Yep.
I think it gives it a sense of identity.
Really?
Yeah. Because we...
I mean, even, you know, the mascot for the college is a Voyageur. So I think it creates a connection between the identity of a Voyageur and the park, and people might want to know where that comes from.
That history.
Yeah.
Interesting, the Voyageurs were mineral, were extractors, you know. They were here for pelts. And when I think of the identity of the falls, I think of Boys of Cascade now, but it's PCA or something like that. And, but I like that. I like what you're seeing in the long run a lot more. I think this is a much more, I think this one gives back for a lot longer. Not that Boys of Cascade didn't give a lot to this community. I mean, aside from jobs, they, you know, they were good civic partners.
Has shown you some of the more important rules for ski safety. It is up to you to see that these rules are not violated. The military striking power of your patrol, the ultimate success of your mission, and very possibly your life itself may depend upon these rules.